You know, he's a terrific player. He's a complete player. And, you know, when you have a, and I said this before, when you have a 6'8 player who really understands how to play, he can dribble, pass, and shoot, he can post up, he can play in the press, he can play in the zone. I mean, he's got a feel. You know, he doesn't rattle. There's no panic in him at all.
Fran, you came out full court, pressed them. Strategy was just to see how your team would play that, or you figured that's the best way to win?
We need to practice playing that way because we're going to want to play that way a lot. And I thought it was pretty good. It was not good at the start of the second half. You know, we're up 23. I think we're a little bit content at that point to trade baskets. And, you know, 23, you know, with the three-point shot anymore, is just not that many possessions. So you've got to be able to take 23 and get it to 30, get it to 35. And ultimately, we did that, but it took us a while.
Is this like a perfect game, though, because you got to play all your guys and you got them a lot of minutes, and especially the young guys who need to learn pretty fast?
Well, yeah, we had the young guys not only on the floor a lot, we had them in together a lot. And, you know, you would never have known that they were young guys. They weren't mistake makers at that point in time. You know, I thought Oglesby had some really good looks. You know, he'll make 8 of those in another night. But he was solid. I mean, White was great. Olesini was great. And I thought Josh played well.
McCabe looks a lot more comfortable moving up front.
McCabe, when he came in the game, he gave us great minutes right away. He ran the floor. He finished inside. He's got a different style of play than Malson does. And the beauty of him is he can score inside and out. I mean, he's really using that 239 pounds well. But then if you don't find him in the zone or on the break, he'll stop and shoot that. And I can play him at 3. He just knows where to go. He knows where to be, and that's important.
Were you preserving Cartwright, trying to keep his legs fresh?
It was not one of his better nights. No question about that. Marvel played better when I put Marvel in the second half. And then once we got to the point where I would have put Price back in, I wasn't going to do it.
Happier with what you got from Melson?
I thought Melson was great. You know, he gave us energy. He was active. He was active early. He helped us against the press. He didn't make a ton of mistakes. No turnovers. I thought he was terrific.
When Bryce tried to dunk it on a 3-on-1 break and you took him out shortly after that, was that just making a point?
No, I wasn't trying to embarrass him. I just didn't think he was playing real well at that time. It wasn't just that play. It was the previous couple plays. We had a 3-on-1. We had a number of opportunities that we should have converted. And I thought he was getting a little bit too fancy at times, trying to make a great play. Just make the simple, solid play. That's who he is. He'll be fine. I mean, he's a great person. He's a terrific player. He's been practicing extremely well. Played well in our exhibition. He'll be fine.
At times it looked like the interior defense wasn't probably what you wanted.
Well, they had to spread out a little bit, but we were jumping into passing lanes. I think it's hard to evaluate that, once you get to a lead. I thought our defense was really good early, both full and half court. Our intensity level was good. Our concentration was good. I was impressed with that.
You look at Eric May's line coach. He didn't shoot maybe as well as you'd hope. 5 assists and 2 steals. Those are the kind of numbers you can win with, aren't they?
Not only that, but he's always in the right place now. He has good feel. He was in the middle of our press offense. If he was on the weak side, he was over where he should have been, so they didn't get much. I just been really impressed with him. Just his overall approach. From when last season ended, it would have been easy for him to get angry and, blame, point fingers as to why he was not in the starting lineup at the end of the year. He just went back to work. And I thought from that moment, really, I think dedicated himself to being a better player. And what you're seeing is a much more complete basketball player. Now, he could have a night where he goes 7 or 8 for 10, and then he's got a huge night. But, defensively, he's been tremendous. He's handling the ball. He's not turning the ball over. He's finding people. And I've been really impressed with him.
Do you think you get Bromer back Monday?
I think it's a good chance. He's going to practice tomorrow full, and then we'll see how he holds up If he holds up well, we'll practice him on Sunday. If he holds up well, they will play him on Monday. If he has any setback at all, if there's any soreness, we won't.
Is that it?